As I mentioned, there's a shocking story of censorship, cancel culture, discrimination, call it what you will, that's come out of Western Australia today. The WA Labor government, incredibly, has a policy of not hiring out state government venues to organisations that run political arguments it disagrees with. These are not Labor venues. These are venues that belong to the citizens of Western Australia. Yet the McGowan Labor government is using these public resources to censor public debate, to shut some groups down. And the group they are shutting down now, the group they are shutting out, is the Australian Christian Lobby. The ACL have been prevented from booking the Albany Entertainment Centre or the Perth Concert Hall, both run by the Perth Theatre Trust, under a policy that declares it will not accept bookings where the content of the event does not represent the views of the West Australian government or the vast majority of Western Australians. Wow. Who decides that? This is not Cuba. This is not Beijing. This is Perth, Western Australia. And this is wrong. Let's bring in the Western Australian director of the Australian Christian Lobby, Peter Abetz. Peter, Jesus, as we know, cast the moneylenders out of the temple, but now the Christians can't even get into an entertainment centre.
It seems that way. It's quite staggering, to be honest. We first tried to hire the Perth Concert Hall in Perth, and when that was declined, we never thought that much of it because there's plenty of other suitable venues, but we've got over 700 supporters in the regional town of Albany in the southwest, and so we wanted the biggest venue in town, and that's the Albany Entertainment Centre. And when we made inquiries, date was available, we booked, filled in the forms, and then we got a response saying, sorry, you can't hire it because we don't hire it because of your organisation has political motives. Oh, there you go.
Well, it's outrageous. I had in my notes, I was sitting down here, I was going to make a note to ask you a question about whether you are political, whether the event was going to be political, but it's an abomination. I should not ask that question. It doesn't matter what you want to use the entertainment complex for, you should be allowed to hire it.
Well, look, our view is that the Equal Opportunity Act 1984, Section 62, it specifically states that you're not allowed to discriminate in the provision of services and hiring of facilities and that type of thing on the basis of a person's political views or religious beliefs. So to say that Martin Isles, who is very well known through the Truth of It podcast that he does, it's a mix of, he speaks about a current issue and then brings biblical truth to bear on it. Now, obviously not everybody's going to agree with what Martin Isles says. We respect that. But we believe that the fact that the government is saying that you cannot hire this venue because you espouse traditional Christian values, I find that absolutely outrageous. And it really is, in my understanding, you know, the High Court has ruled that we've got that implied right of political communication, and here we've got the government saying, no, you can't. So
I agree with you. It's outrageous. It would be outrageous if it was happening to any group, yet this policy seems to be highly political. You mentioned the Equal Opportunities Act. You mentioned that implied right of political freedom that's come out of High Court cases. But religious freedom is one of the few freedoms that's actually mentioned in our Australian Constitution. Are you guys going to take this the whole hog? Are you just going to rent another venue and accept this defeat? Or are you going to challenge this through the courts?
Look, we've written to the Perth Theatre Trust asking them to review the decision because we believe it's wrong. And we've also written to the minister pointing out that we believe that the policy itself is actually contravention of the Equal Opportunity Act. So we want to first give them the opportunity to set their house in order. But if they refuse to do that, and incidentally, the Perth Theatre Trust is sort of a semi-autonomous body, but the minister does have the power to direct them to do things and he has to approve their policies. So at some point, the minister must have approved this hiring policy and perhaps didn't think it through as clearly as what he might have and not picked up on the fact that this is it's just simply unacceptable, I don't think, legally. And just it just doesn't pass the pub test to say that if you don't agree with the views of the West Australian government, well, anybody at the moment, if you don't agree with Labor views, you're not allowed to hire a venue. I mean, it's that's just bad. Outrageous.
It's not bad. Kim Jong-il would be... he'd be pleased with these arrangements. Now, you're going to give them another chance then. Let's hope they come to the right decision. But they need to change the policy, not just this decision. But then rather than being good Christians and turning the other cheek, then you'll take them on?
Look, we certainly plan to take it further if they don't acknowledge that there is that they need to do something different. We'll wait and see what comes up, but we certainly would take it up with the Equal Opportunity Commission. I'm not a lawyer, so I'll leave that to the legal people at ACL to work out what the next step is. But that's certainly being explored. But we're hopeful that common sense would prevail, because the right across the political spectrum, there's been absolute outrage at this decision of the Perth Theatre Trust.
As there should be.
And the sad thing is... because the big problem is, it's not only for us. We believe that this has impact on a lot of other groups as well, eventually.
Exactly.
And so we want to push back on this, because it's a matter of freedom of speech, freedom of to associate, and also the right to political communication.
That is absolutely correct, Peter. Thanks so much for joining us. And that's why I wish you Godspeed in victory here.
Thanks very much, Chris. Thanks for your time.
Peter Abetz there, who's the Western Australian State Director of the Australian Christian Lobby. The point here is, it's about Christians now, but what other group could be rejected from a facility in Western Australia? As Peter said, it's much broader than about this particular act. It's about freedom of speech, freedom of association, and that is just outrageous, what's going on in WA right now. We'll keep tabs on that.